Dear students, today we will discuss the sterically assisted reaction. So for explaining this, we have the 4 tertiary butyl cyclohexyl tosylate compound sololysis. We have cis 4 tertiary butyl cyclohexyl tosylate group. This is the cis isomer, and which second is the trans isomer. Cis 4 tertiary butyl cyclohexyl tosylate, then 4 tertiary butyl, this is our trans cyclohexyl tosylate. Okay, during the sololysis of this compound, we have obtained a transition intermediate state. Like that state is you obtain. And during this reaction, this OTS group remove at first stage, remove, and you obtain the carbocation-like or TS. Okay, this is a transition state. And when you carry out sololysis reaction on this compound, you found that the rate of reaction for cis isomer is 3 to 4 times more than trans isomer. You observe in this case the axial substituents, and in this compound it's a more crowding situation is found in cis isomer, because in this case CH3 is there. Therefore, lots of steric strain you observe in the cis 4 tertiary butyl cyclohexyl tosylate. Now, what is meaning of steric assisted reaction? This reaction, crowded substituents or crowded compounds or axial compounds or crowded compounds react faster than the less crowded substituents. Okay, therefore, in a steric assisted reaction, steric requirement means that there is a steric crowding in a ground state is higher than in a transition state. Therefore, we can say that in a ground state there is crowding than in a transition state. And at the finally, in this reaction, we can say that crowding substituents react faster, because when you see when from this molecule you obtain the transition state, the energy of this molecule, if you consider the energy of our cis isomer, is higher than energy of our trans isomer, because trans isomer is a stable isomer, and the stable compound, the energy is lower. In this trans isomer, it is equatorial substituency is there, and at this position there is an axial substituency. In steric assisted reaction, you found that the highly crowded substituents is react faster, or highly crowded compound react faster than the less crowded compounds. This is our steric assisted reaction. Now the compound is stable, its energy is less. Okay, in this case we given the name, the energy of this compound is at the ground state is, if you consider Fa, and energy of, sorry, if we consider the Fe, that is the for the equatorial isomer. For this compound we consider the energy Fa, that is the axial one. Okay, now for both the cases you obtain the same TS. Okay, therefore for this compound you obtain the TS in this, that is we given the name F star E, and for this also we give the F star E. Then the energy of activation means the energy from ground state to the it excite transition state. Okay, the energy of this, that is equal to delta F star A, that is energy of activation, and energy of activation for this delta F star F E. You found that energy of activation for cis isomer is less, for cis isomer is less. Therefore, the cis isomer react faster than the trans isomer. Okay, this energy difference between ground state to the ground state of axial, that is the it is means the delta F A star minus delta F E is nothing but our delta F, or the free energy. Okay, difference between the free energy is given by the energy of activation of axial molecule minus energy of activation of equatorial molecule. That is the free energy available for to do the work is, we can calculate by the taking difference between two activation energy. Okay, now we have clear that the sterically assisted reaction is a kind of reaction where the more crowded substituent react faster than the less crowded substituents. Okay, now we have second example, that is oxidation of tertiary butyl cyclohexanol by using CrO3. Okay, in this case we have the first isomer is a cis isomer, cis tertiary butyl cyclohexanol, and second isomer is trans tertiary butyl cyclohexanol. You remember that tertiary butyl is always at equatorial position because it is a highly bulkier group, therefore it not prefers the axial position. That's why we use this tertiary butyl at the fourth position and maintain the cis isomers of both these compounds. For number of examples we have used the tertiary butyl groups at four position. Now we, in this case we have using CrO3 as a oxidizing agent. Okay, therefore we obtain the intermediate step is like that, oxygen, there is attack on our CrO3. Okay, this attack and this lone pair will take the this hydrogen. Okay, this you obtain the oxygen and OH. This is our chromate ester compound. Okay, cis chromate ester compound, and in this case when you add the CrO3 you obtain the this kind of intermediate CrO and OH. Okay, then in this case hydrogen is there and hydrogen is at axial position. Both are the chromate ester. Okay, when you see this compound, okay, chromate ester of this, this is a our axial, CR is there. This is our chromate ester. Its energy is higher than the, okay, its energy is higher than the our equatorial chromate ester, because this is, there is a 1,3 diaxial interaction is there, this axial group 1,3 diaxial interaction, and also along with there is a bulkier tertiary butyl will be same side of this axial chromate ester. In this case the butyl groups and the ester, chromate ester is the away from each other, therefore the it is a stable one, and if the compound is stable its energy is less. If the compound, okay, when you compare these two compounds, it is unstable compound and its energy is higher. Okay, therefore energy of the equatorial substituent, that is Fe, is lower than the energy of Fe. Now the second step in this compound is the abstract of hydrogen by H2O and obtain the at the last our product. Okay, H2O, and you have obtained a transition state. This transition state is looks like that, bond breaking and bond making, we have shown like that. Is this bond is break and bond also make, this bond is break and bond also make, and there is hydrogen is pick up by our OH2, that is H2O molecule. Same situation, transition state you obtain in this case is like that, hydrogen is pick up by our H2O molecule, and this bond there is making of carbonyl group, then CR, this bond is break, this bond also second bond is break, and you obtain like that transition state. Okay, when you compare in the transition state or in RDS, okay, this is the rate determining state. Second step is pick up of hydrogen and forms the cyclohexone, that is a ketonic group is obtained in the OH, in the place of OH you obtain the C double bond O. At the last stage in RDS, bond breaking and bond making is a simultaneous process, therefore the energy of this and energy of this, when you compare its previous situation, you found that the trace is relieved in case of cis isomer is higher than trace is relieved in a trans isomer. Okay, therefore when you compare that its energy of activation, you found that the energy of activation for this molecule is definitely less for the energy of activation for equatorial isomer. Therefore how we compare this how either this cis tertiary butyl cyclohexane react faster, because the in bond breaking and in RDS step bond breaking and bond making is simultaneous, therefore trace is relieved than the previous step. Okay, trace relieve in a cis isomer at a TS or in bond breaking, bond making process is because in bond breaking, bond making the CrO3 is goes away, is to this molecule is abstract, and you obtain at the last, you obtain the straight relieve your this compound. Okay, the oxidation of alcohol is takes place and you obtain the very trace relieve. Both compounds there is trace relieve, and in RDS or in transition state you found that trace is very much relieved in a transition state than trans isomer. Therefore this compound react faster than the trans compound. This is a also a type of the sterically
assisted reaction. In sterically assisted reactant, acyl group react faster, or bulky when acyl group or bulkier group react faster, or the steric crowded compound react faster in sterically assisted reaction. Now we have again one example is there. That example is SN2 reaction. Okay, we have carried out this reaction in tertiary butyl cyclohexene iodide, that is cis isomer and trans isomer tertiary butyl. Okay, in both cases we use the iodide minus as a nucleophile. Okay, therefore our leaving group and attacking group both are the same. Therefore this reaction is the symmetrical SN2 reaction, where breaking group, that is in this case iodide is a breaking group, and attacking group are same. Therefore in SN2 reaction it is a that is a binuclear reaction. Okay, it's a nucleophilic substitution or bimolecular reaction. Okay, both molecules is involved in the rate determining state. In SN2 reaction, attack of the nucleophile and breaking of nucleophile is takes simultaneously. Okay, therefore you found that when there is acyl group is there, iodide, and attack group is iodide, you found that in both cases transition state is same. Remember that in both cases transition state is same, but sterically crowding in ground state for acyl group is higher than the steric grounded in the transition state. Okay, therefore your transition state is same, then we can predict its energetic, the energy of this compound. Okay, this is the unstable compound because there is a acyl big group is there, therefore unstable compound, therefore its energy is higher okay than this. Okay, therefore energy of lower for this molecule because it is a stable one molecule, because bulkier iodide group is the equatorial one. Therefore for the same its transition state is the same, therefore its energy of activation, if you consider the acyl group, then it is a Fa at ground state, F star A at the excited state, in this Fe at the ground state and F star E at the excited state. Therefore delta F star E is the activation energy for trans isomer, and delta F star A is the activation energy for the cis isomer. Therefore activation energy is lower for the cis isomer, therefore these molecule react faster. And you found that if your iodide group or iodine is at the acyl position, then your nucleophile I minus will attack from the equatorial position. And if your iodide group is at equatorial position, then bulkier group is there, therefore iodide minus attack from the axial position. Remember that if group is at axial position, iodide minus attack from the equatorial position, and if group is the from equatorial position, then I minus attack from the axial position. Okay, therefore when you compare this reaction, this molecule found that the transition state, after the transition state, the molecule option is stable, and also axial trace is relieved by the, because in a transition state bond breaking and bond making are simultaneously done in SN2 reaction. Okay, therefore in this reaction he found that the same molecule is obtained at the at the last this molecule obtained acyl iodide and this molecule obtained the equilibrium. Very trace is relevant in the product than the acyl group. The product is obtained, the less crowded product is obtained, and also in a transition state the steric crowding is relieved than the in a ground state. Okay, that in this way this reaction, okay, symmetrical asymmetry reaction is a also a kind of sterically assisted reaction. Okay, this is all about the sterically assisted reaction. Some more reaction we will see in the next lecture of the sterically assisted reaction. In sterically assisted reaction we have seen that the stereochemical requirement in a ground state is more than the stereochemical requirement in the transition state. In other words, we can say that the crowded compound or acyl compound or acyl substituents react faster than the equatorial substituent. This is all about the sterically assisted reaction. Thank you very much.